and welcome to Monet Cafe. This is Susan Jenkins, and I am so excited. I don't normally share my face, you know that, from my videos, and it's because I don't like to wear makeup, but you guys don't care because you're family. But I just wanted to personally thank everyone who has joined the Facebook page for Monet Cafe. It has blessed me more than I can say. And also what is so neat is it's exactly what I had hoped for, that you guys would start helping each other and sharing amongst each other. And there is some amazing art on there. I'm blown away by your talent. And I love the new people asking questions. Absolutely put art on there and ask for critiques. Just share your art and just keep doing what you're doing because it's awesome. But today I actually got a great question on the Facebook channel, which was if I could please share a little bit about the difference between warm and cool colors. A lot of times I'm doing a video and I just throw that out there. This is a warm green or a cool green. And that's a great question. I remember the exact same question. All these things you ask is exactly what I was wondering when I first started. So I thought today would be a good opportunity to do this. So this is gonna be a Monet Cafe quick tip. And I'm going to take some of my pastels I have here. I got some Terry Ludwig pastels, and these are the greens. They actually look a little blue, but it's a great opportunity to show the differences in cool and warm colors. So that's what we're gonna be doing today, and I hope you learned something. And again, thank you so much. Anybody new here who wants to join our Facebook page, you just find Monet Cafe on Facebook. It's not a page, it's a closed group, so you will have to ask to join. I'll try to remember to put the link in the about section of this video. All right, guys, pardon my little ear things here, but my microphone makes you hear me better. All right, let's do it. Okay, guys, so here we go for a Monet Cafe quick tip. I thought I'd just walk into my studio here and kind of show you warts and all because it is a mess right now. But this is where I work, and it's a beautiful day here in Tampa, Florida. Got a nice view here outside my window, which is nice. And this is where my little sanctuary is, and I love to hear about you guys and where you find your little places to escape and do art. For many years, I worked just out of a little corner of my kitchen. So wherever you can find your little happy place to create. So what we're doing today is I'm going to talk about the difference between warm colors and cool colors. And it's a great opportunity with this set of Terry Ludwig cool greens. I love this set. And I thought, okay, I'm gonna integrate them into my pastel boxes. This is my system. And if you want more on how to store your pastels or how to arrange your pastel palette, you can see a video that I did on pastel storage tips. I'll try to share that link as well. And but this video is more just about the difference between warm colors and cool colors. What does that mean? How do you tell? And it's really not all that hard, but you do get a better eye for it as you work and as you go on. Some people, you know, just like all kinds of different gifts that people have, you may have a strength in one thing that someone else doesn't. You may have an eye for composition. You just may naturally see good composition and create that. Some people may have an eye for color and value. They may just easily see color and value. And some may have an eye for warm and cool colors. And the reason I don't have to have my pastels arranged so perfectly, I do think I'm going to divide my boxes into four sections. I kind of have them grouped a little bit. But the reason I'm not that fussy about it is because that happens to be my gift, is I just see value very easy and I see color very easily. So, you know, everybody's got their different things. So I have to work real hard at other things that aren't my gift. So if this is not your gift, seeing warm and cool tones, then this is going to be a great video for you. Now, what I want to show right here is this box of greens. The way they're arranged right now, like I said, I kind of sort of have them in sections. You can't really tell, but you can tell if you start to look at what I'm going to describe as warm versus cool. Now, using just greens as an example, warm greens are going to lean more towards the yellow end of the color wheel or spectrum. Cool greens are going to lean more towards the blue end of the color spectrum. So in this box right here, you can see that my warmer greens, let me see before I answer if you guys can tell where the warmer greens would be. They would be the ones that are closer to yellow. Okay, I bet you've already discovered it's going to be these over here. These are all my warmer greens. Now, I have it arranged to where they're kind of going up in value from lighter to darker, but more up to, these are more of my neutral greens. You know, they're kind of in between. They're kind of dull and kind of dead in color. These are still kind of warmer greens up here that I have my dark darks. But now, if you come this way, I've got my warmer tones gradually going into cooler tones, a little lighter in value, okay, or the lighter values of them. And then they are just gradually going up here until into the cooler greens, okay? Now, what's interesting is the way I have, this is how I used to have my boxes sitting on my table before I started putting them in drawers, again, just to save space. But they're arranged so that the cool greens are next to the warm blues, okay, for the most part, okay? Now, that's kind of one of the harder ones is the blues. Well, how is a blue warm versus cool? Well, if the blues are closer to the greens, that goes more towards, what is green made of? It's made of blue and yellow. So greens obviously all have a little bit of yellow in them, okay? Even these, they have some yellow, just not as much as here. But they have more blue, okay? So your warmer blues are gonna be closer to the greens. Your cooler blues are gonna be closer to the real blues, more towards the primary color of blue, okay? So that's just kind of a little bit of an idea. But this, I find this helps me a little bit because you've got some almost crossover colors in here. Like for example, I've got a color right here that is, it's kind of, isn't that kind of in between? Let me do it on my newsprint up here and you'll see. I mean, is that a blue? Is it a green? It's kind of in between, you know? So some of them are very close, but, you know, hopefully you're kind of getting the idea there. Like right in here, look at this one here. So I actually do have one that would pass more for a green in here. Look at this color here. This is a nice bright. Sometimes I have them arranged just with brightness too. But that's kind of, it's kind of a green, isn't it? In between a blue and a green. So they're kind of like that little gentle division between the blue and the green. It's where you get warm blues versus cool greens. I hope that makes sense. And so I kind of do that even with reds and with yellows. And it's based on if you take the color wheel and you do, I wish I had that up here. I don't have my color wheel handy. And you do your primary colors, you can just see where in the color wheel is that color closer to, and that's going to make it whether it's a cooler or a warmer. Okay, so let's put away these Terry Ludwig cool greens. Now you might look at this box at first, or someone who's just starting with art or has no experience in art and say, those aren't all greens. There's blues in that box, and there's some that look like lavenders. So why is this considered cool green? Well, have you ever noticed there's certain times that you're trying to create a scene or you're just looking out in the real world at nature and there's an atmosphere where everything is more cooler in color. It's not that rich color where there's a warm sunshine and things tend to more warm colors when the sun is bright or warm in the sky. So this might be more of a moody, hazy day where things just appear that more bluish, cooler atmosphere. So these would be more of the tones that you would use in an atmosphere like that. Sometimes there still might be some warmer greens in that atmosphere, but there's going to be some cooler tones as well. And even some of your shadows will be like the lavendery colors. So that's why this box is considered cool greens, even though they don't all look exactly green, you know, like I said, to more of the untrained eye. So let's go ahead and explore this and try to put some of these tones or colors away. So I'm going to choose this right here and I'm going to let you guys help me with this. Okay. This is one of those nice in between. So I want you to help me. I'm going to mark it up here so you can kind of get an idea of the value and the color. I just love pastels. That's just gorgeous. Anyway, so let's take a look at my system here and my palette and let you help me. So as I pull this around, you guys take a look and you think about where this might go. Okay, over here we know these are the cooler blues, okay? They're more towards just the regular blue. Okay, so definitely not. Okay, let's bring it around here. Looks like this is leaning more towards the warm blues, huh? And it's very interesting. Look at that. Right around in here somewhere, okay? All right, we're getting into the cooler greens and a little bit of a darker value. Not dark, dark, like here, okay? But it's definitely kind of in between these blues and the greens, okay? And I would consider this kind of more like a neutral one too, kind of like I have some of my neutrals here. I'm actually going to be taking one of my, in my system with these boxes, I'm going to make one of them just neutrals. That's what Richard McKinley has. He really recommends using neutrals in your paintings and having them sectioned off. So that's one of the things I'm going to be doing. So that's kind of a neat one there. You can kind of see how it's in between the blues and the greens there, okay? So let's take another one. Let's take, I apologize, my color on my iPhone doesn't look exactly the same as the color that my eye sees. So sometimes when I say, oh, look how green that is, it may not look as green to you. Okay, let's do this right here. I happen to really love that. Wow. Okay, so is this going to lean more towards the warmer blues or the cooler blues? Okay, and I think you're probably seeing that it doesn't have a lot of yellow in it, okay? So it's definitely more of a blue than it is a green. And again, my eyes can see this better than you can on the phone, but it's going to be somewhere more in this area. It might be a little lighter value. Yes, I think it is than that. That's very subtle difference, but okay, let's do another one. Let's look at maybe here. Okay, what do you think? You're probably already getting the hang of this. You can almost instantly see, let me pull back. Look at that. It's going to be one of the warmer greens, okay? So it's going to be more in here. And this one also doesn't have, you see how this is not as bright as that one? It's more of, gets more of that neutrally type of shade to it or color. Okay, so we're getting the hang of it. Maybe just one more. Let's look here. This one actually has so much yellow in it. And it looks more yellow to me with my eye again, that it almost, if I was to take my box that has my yellows, I have a box that has yellows and oranges in it, and I was to sit that box here, these would be like on that border between green and yellow. Okay, so you see how it's all like it's almost like it's a circle, and everything kind of gradually goes into one thing or the other. Okay, so that's pretty much the idea of warm and cool colors. So now you know when you're working on your art, and when I'm talking about warm and cool colors, you'll have an idea of what it is. And also, please utilize this in your paintings. If you have a warm scene with a lot of sunshine and warm colors, definitely use some warmer tones. And you use the cooler tones in the shadows. Cooler tones are definitely good for shadows because the sun's not shining there. So I really hope that helps. And again, I'm just so excited to see all of you guys connecting and joining with each other on the Facebook channel or Facebook closed group page. So keep sharing your art. I'm loving it. Keep helping each other. And mostly just keep enjoying this journey. It is such a beautiful experience in life to just enjoy the beauty of creation and to try to create it ourselves. So thanks guys. I really enjoyed this little lesson. I'll try to give more quick tips, and I hope to have a full painting video coming soon. All right. See ya. Bye.